Guys, welcome back to Seat Story Cup. Artosis, Alesh, and Gara here. Gara, I'm so sorry. That was...
Never lucky, baby rage.
Ripping pepperonis.
I had a quick question. I was actually watching that whole match. Do you play Muster in that deck, in that Paladin deck?
Yeah, I think it was two copies of it in my deck.
Two copies, not just one copy.
I triple checked before the game.
Okay.
And also,
and True Silver Champion.
Do you play
also?
Owl?
Yeah, I do.
Equality
as well. True Silver as well.
I did see the Equality.
Oh, he played it. I missed that.
After
one.
You drew a bunch of cards and didn't have mana to.
Oh, okay. He didn't have mana to play it.
Yeah. But anyways, before we start this next match, poor Gara, let's go ahead and take a look at the Take TV page. We want to talk about some of the stuff going on with these sponsors that are pretty awesome. This is where you should be watching it anyways. It's a beautiful page. Scroll down, check out Kingwin, and click on it. All right, and now what you're looking for here is a Maz with a sombrero on, basically. You just click around, find it. Save the link. The link is up there. That's where your link is if you use Chrome. If you don't use Chrome, what are
Who
you
doesn't?
Actually using?
Opera.
Internet Explorer.
Yeah,
Internet Explorer.
What?
God.
It's good
this
stuff.
Is not 2002. No one uses Opera anymore.
Mozilla Firefox. Some people still use Mozilla.
Okay, some people do. That's really weird.
Mozilla
still.
Is actually decent, yeah.
Yeah, it's decent. But anyways, go to facebook.com/taketv and scroll down here. Okay, you scroll down. There's some funny things. This is the type of thing you're looking for. See those? And then you can just click on here and submit it, and you can win some really cool stuff. So definitely go check that out and try to win.
Easy.
Yeah.
What can you win, though?
You win 20 euro balance or Hearthstone card packs.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, it quite is. You can maybe open up some golden musters or something like that.
Yeah, if you miss them in your deck or something, right, Gara? Right?
Yeah.
Who doesn't need cards?
So the next match is going to be Amaz versus Tice, if I'm correct, right? It's going to be the final match of this group.
Yeah, and then we'll be moving on to the second half of today, which will be the last two groups of the round of 32. But only one of these guys will be moving on, two of the big favorites of the tournament out of this group of death.
So this group is really stacked.
Yeah, I looked at it. I originally did think it was the group of death, and I did not even think that Ignite would get out, let alone crush the group.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah. But I mean, like, Ignite was preparing. Like, he told me, like, I'm his roommate in a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
He told me that he was preparing, but he wasn't really testing. He just brought a really good strategy of one of his really good friends that he was crashing ESL with it and stuff like that. And it seems like it's working for him. He just, like, straight up has a deck list, like, deck builds for a Hunter. He just, like, counters the Hunter just with all of his decks, and he feels like that's a good way to go.
Just that nobody in the group played Hunter.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Still got out in first place. That's how good of a strategy
That's how good
is.
Strategy it is.
No, actually, he said himself that he was lucky. Like, he noticed, like, he drew really well in all
and
his games.
And the brawls for Antonidas. Oh,
God. Just craziness. Krip was actually calling all of that. Every time bad things happen, he was like, watch this. Watch. And then he would name the terrible thing that was going to happen to a player.
That's sad.
Now, speaking of this matchup, right? Okay, so we have Tice the Druid Mage Paladin Warlock and Amaz the Druid Mage Warlock Warrior. So, Warrior Paladin, the only difference. Who takes this match, though?
I mean, it depends on bans as well. But...
The guy with the better draws, I guess. That's how I felt.
Where's that salt shaker on the screen?
I feel like Amaz's Warrior doesn't really do much against the whole Tice's lineup, which could be a really good advantage for Tice, I feel like. But it's like only thing I really see.
What was interesting, that against me, Tice banned Paladin. And Amaz doesn't have Paladin, so I wonder... Which is also interesting because Paladin was for a long time Amaz's main deck, like the last two marks, like on Leda as well. So it's interesting that he didn't even brought it.
I think this is the first time we're seeing Warlock from either of them, but they're both going to be going Warlock, guys.
Yeah, no Warlock ban this time.
Yeah. I expect Tice to run just classic
Handlock. Oh my god.
He really likes Handlock.
Yeah, Tice's Pally is banned.
And is this a zoo?
Maybe because he's using Sixto's account, it was like already pre-made.
He looked at it, he's like, oh yeah, that looks pretty good.
I'm going to use that one.
I'm just going to use that one. So Zoo, we haven't seen Zoo for a while in competitive Hearthstone, I feel like. The deck was quite not as good as it used to be because of all the Belchers, you know, that kind of stuff, Masters 4 Battles, those cards kind of were stomping zoo.
But that open is like the absolute dream.
Definitely.
Flame Imp into coin, Flame Imp. Take 6 damage, but you have freaking...
Oh, the silence on our silence on Fire Elemental.
That's like, a good move.
Yeah, that's like one of the best moves you can do right there.
There you can see how much he's pressured.
Mm-hmm.
Like usually you save the silence for all the death rattle minions.
And like egg or whatever.
Looks like it's just Demon Lock, so probably no Molten Giants.
I feel like this might still be just like hand lock with
no Mountain Giants.
With no Mountain Giants, no Mountain Giants. You just still play Twilight Drakes, Moltens, and you just play Void Colors with Mal'Ganis.
Mm-hmm. But the sick thing about Amasant is that he has the double power warming, so he can clear the big first big threat.
Yeah.
That's actually a really big deal.
Not only just that, but he can also just like do burst damage from nowhere, which is pretty important as well. Like
he
just...
No. He can play around Moltens and then OTK him.
Yeah, exactly. That's just so good.
Uh-oh. Speaking of Moltens,
oh, wow, right that's here.
If he attacks with all this, he's going to be in trouble.
So what is actually interesting, isn't this lethal? It is lethal, right? Night Juggler into Power Roaming, and it's lethal.
Eight.
You just Power Roaming the Spider, and it's lethal.
Okay, so that's 8, 11, 12,
oh, yeah,
13.
That's lethal. No, 14.
He doesn't see it.
He doesn't see it.
Oh, that wasn't Miss Lethal. Oh, damn.
Yeah, the Spiders will proc.
Will proc with the...
That's 2, 3, 6, 7, plus 8, 15. That would have been one off lethal.
Well, no.
No, you attack if the Spider has one attack.
Yeah, it has one attack as well.
No, I know.
So it's 8 plus...
5 plus 8.
It's 13.
13.
Oh, yeah.
Plus
2
is
15. Okay.
It was
you got me there.
These pros missing lethal, man. God, is there still time for me to register for this tournament?
I was caught up by
I got through groups. Like, no, I mean, I'm just quick thinking. Sorry.
That's okay. Just off lethal. You'll get an extra.
I was about to say, without them, they're not miss lethal. It really depends on this turn for how much damage he pushes,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Because he has the double Moltens, and that's his comeback play. So he went to 13, and it looks like...
And he got him just right.
Yeah.
And, I mean, playing taunt. He's dead now. That's it. It's over.
Yeah.
Sick game.
Yep.
Well, you know, this is how I remember Zoo. Mm-hmm. Why are people not playing Zoo? There's the question.
Like this always was the case, like in this matchup, because usually Handlock has answers. They have Shadow Flame or Hellfire or some kind of answer,
mm-hmm.
and just Tice didn't draw it. You know, so if you don't draw it, this matchup was always like this.
Yeah.
So you'll see the double power roaming and burst damage.
That is actually very interesting that we saw this next card, what he drew. He drew a Void Call.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's like normal hand... No, wait. Oh, it's from...
No, that's from the Zoo.
It's from
the Zoo deck.
Yeah.
So I guess...
That's interesting. Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
And he didn't show it.
I guess that's just for his Doom Guards, right? So...
Mm-hmm. Maybe he has more, right?
You
don't know.
Maybe he has more. Maybe he has like Mal'Ganis in it with Implosions. Maybe.
It's cool. A Zoo deck with Mal'Ganis.
Yeah, and Implosions.
I think we're talking about Demon Lock with Flame Imps what we're talking about.
Demon Lock, yeah, probably. Okay, so we won't see any more Zoo at least. That's out of the way.
Tice right now is like, oh my god, I can't believe it was Zoo.
I think so too. Like, I don't think I would expect Zoo at the moment. So that's why. This is actually good for him right now, but in future for Amaz, like for top 16, if he gets there, it's going to be less advantage, you know, because now people actually mulligan into those AoEs.
It might not be because we can change the decks for later on. So he might have just brought Zoo for the group stages for the surprise factor.
Yeah. Speaking of which, you think with the gang boss, we're going to see more Zoo decks now, right?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely. I think the people...
He seems pretty crazy.
Yeah.
EU rank 1 legendary is playing Zoo right now.
Mm.
Not kidding.
That's like generally the case. Is someone's like, look at my new Zoo deck. It's 2 cards different from
the last
Zoo deck.
No, like now, I don't remember who it is right now, but he's rank 1 legendary EU.
Did he just climb because I played with RDU earlier to rank 1 EU?
Yeah, I think he played like it yesterday. So maybe.
Where's RDU? He has to get back
from
on
him,
it.
Maybe?
Yeah, we just crushed with Mech Shaman
like a few hours ago?
To rank 1. Yeah.
Okay,
this
so maybe he took
RDU
it from him. Maybe he took it from him. But like, so he more probably is like rank 2 then. Oh. So yeah. So
well, only rank 2. Do I really even want to play?
Oh
the deck?
Yeah, like rank 2 legendary. That's
it's not
whatever.
So good.
Hey, Cookie, who remembers rank 2, right?
No, yeah. I don't.
That's only 40 points. Like 40 points for BlizzCon.
That's nothing. How many points do you need to get into BlizzCon? Do you think
5?
Someone did. Well, minimum five, but how many is going to be like the qual that gets you two up, do you
like
think? Someone has to have done the math.
200-something, 250, something okay. like that, I would expect.
Yeah, only top 10 has like a really big advantage,
yeah.
top 10 in points. Mm.
All right, looks like Tice going to be bringing his mage this time, going up against Druid.
Yeah, that was like a good pick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is really good for Tice because this matchup is really favorite for him.
Yeah, that's exactly what he wants, this mm-hmm. matchup.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants the Mad Scientist.
Yeah, Mad Scientist with the mirror entities, that's like what Druid's just like dying to yeah. straight up.
But on the other side, we see an Innovate that's already very good.
Not if it's the only card.
But it's
and it doesn't look like he's drawn anymore, man.
That's interesting.
That works.
Yeah, that works. And the swipe is actually not that great against Mech Mage, but it's still some kind of removal.
Mm.
His hand is very slow for a Mech Mage.
You know, Mech Warper. He's not that good at this game. He didn't draw Mech Warper.
Yeah. Outplayed.
That's all right though, because he's playing against a Druid deck.
Yeah,
and
Amaz is not as good as well either, because he didn't draw into Wildgrowth. So those players kind of lack some skill, Kappa.
Well, I like that they've kind of slowed the game down for mm-hmm. us so we can enjoy it more, because that first game was actually like a
pretty fast
piece of crap. Like, I was just getting warmed up and looking at what the cards were, remembering what Zudex have in them, and then he died.
True. So the turn 3 Belcher is pretty decent. He's going to be followed probably by Shredder. But the question here is if Tice decides to actually destroy his own Mad Scientist just to get secret out.
Probably because
I like it.
It would make sense because mm-hmm. I mean, since he played this, he doesn't have yeah. something like really crappy and weak, right?
And he has to damage the Belcher anyways somehow to kill it with the Yeti.
Yeah, and like there's no point for you to risk like Keeper of the Grove, you know, to silence your Mad Scientist. That would be pretty bad for you, so might as well just get it.
And that's the way how he will get tempo back. And as we can see, he doesn't have like a crappy minion to play, so he has the tempo back soon after this turn.
So I mean, he can just like Shredder, kill the Shredder, get a Doomsayer, so you will be the one who has minions after the Doomsayer.
Yes.
I mean, I got Doomsayer twice in this tournament already from my Shredder. So
are you serious?
I'm serious.
I've been looking for that.
Twice in a row. Twice in a row.
All the fun stuff. Like seriously.
Yeah.
Did you need it, or did it...
No, I actually screwed me over. It screwed me over hardcore. So, I still won the game.
Amaz got this Pagel against me and drew every turn.
Yes. He drew three times right in a row, and then he like beat you with the last card. It was
just one of the few things that happened.
Classic Hearthstone. So, here from Tice, we see that he has some options. He can go like for Blast Mage. He can go for...
Blast Mage
seems pretty good. Mm. I would probably just kill the Belcher Hall Belcher, and then just Blast Mage. Hopefully you hit the Shredder three times.
Yeah, you try to keep the Shredders alive as long mm-hmm. as possible.
Definitely.
I gotta ask you, Gara, between these two, which of these players is the luckier today? Because they both beat you, right? Which one is it?
That's pretty close. Like, that's really close. I think... Yeah, because Tice was, like, unlucky in their game against Ignite. Like, when in his Druid games, he drew really poorly.
Yeah.
So I guess Amaz is slightly luckier.
So you mean Amaz was luckier with his Brawl and surviving Ignite's Antonidas?
Okay. Touché. They both used up their bad luck against Ignite, but they're, like, recharged against me.
Okay, I see. Powered up against you.
Okay, every bad RNG counts, so this one counts mm-hmm. as well, the 1-1.
Wait, did he have a web spinner out?
No.
It was from the Shredder.
From the Shredder.
Oh, okay.
It's a two drop.
This card I only remember from web spinners. So.
It's a two drop. It's the worst card you can get.
So I'm asking go for like Ancient of Lore draw, but that's kind of bad for you since you lose quite a lot of tempo. But I feel like that's still the play, right?
Yeah.
If might decide for like wipe or something, but I just think you need the cards. You need some good cards.
And afterwards you can still swipe.
Exactly.
Like he will trade something in. He will probably trade the Shredder and ping it. That's like the most likely play. And play something for free mana. Yeah, he has something. He will play the Tinker Technician and ping. But first you trade to see if you get like a Doomsayer.
You always gotta check
But it's 50-50. It can be Mana Vermin, then he can't play the Technician. Mm-hmm.
But so I think this is the blast entity. Mage again, right? Here from Thais, probably. Just like hit one, then blast mage.
Yeah, I would say
yeah,
so.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, but...
Unless you get really unlucky, obviously.
But then you probably trade the Shredder. Or
yeah, Shredder. You just want to keep as many
it was a test.
Board.
Isn't it better to trade the Yeti then? Because if you get the Doomsayer, you just screw yourself over. I mean, I would trade the Yeti, man. Just because of experience.
Experience?
Luck experience.
The way things have gone for you today.
All right, if this is like a...
If that is...
it's not a Doomsayer.
He has been out all day today.
Hey,
this guy,
but this guy isn't even bad. Like, it's
no,
pretty good.
He's good.
It's pretty good minion.
Yeah, yeah.
He actually made a lot of funny trades earlier when he popped out of his shard.
Yeah,
he was like giving Cabal Shadow Priest enough to kill the Belcher. Was that your Belcher?
Yeah, that was my.
Yeah,
yeah. I stole it to buff it so I can trade with the Belcher. You stuffed the 4-2, right?
I actually kind of like the stealth for the Yeti right now. You just kind of play around this. Around the swipe a little bit.
No, that doesn't work.
He can't finicky cloak field himself.
He tried.
Imagine if that worked and we're like, oh my god, no one ever
no
tried
No,
Little
boy.
That is
so you have a combo, so good for you.
And then you become a rogue.
Hidden in the shadows.
So that is really bad. He wants to kill the Yeti really badly.
Yeah, that's why I really like the stealth there. Because he could just protect from get protected from swipe.
But he's still a decent play.
Mm. Definitely. So right now, Thais, the Pilot Sky Golem isn't bad at all. Question is it worth it? I mean, you can just push for damage with Anoyotron and Tinkertown Technician. And you can even maybe play Entity, to be honest, if you feel like it.
I wouldn't mind Mirror Entity here.
Mm-hmm.
He obviously doesn't have any little cheap, crappy minions to play.
And it's going to be turn 7, so most likely something like Dr. Boom, you deny Dr. Boom, you deny Lore, you know, that kind of big stuff. So the Entity would be pretty sick as well here.
But he would get punished by Swipe.
Hello.
Not if he plays Anoyotron.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
like a better play.
Yeah, that's a good hedge
right
there.
Yeah, that's a better play.
Pushes for damage, just needs to top deck a couple of fireballs and that's it.
Hey, one more turn, you can BGH this Yeti.
Oh, sweet.
The value. So, here we see that Maz doesn't really have a good play. Swipe is probably the best, because that way he doesn't need to play minions, which he doesn't really want to with the mirror entity up there. And
at this point, you're also afraid of dying. You're down to 14 life. It's like a very bad spot. He's like fighting from behind.
And that's the whole story of like Druid versus Mech Mage matchup, I feel like.
Mm.
Like, unless you play Rag, and you play Rag early on and he doesn't have response to it, this match usually ends up like this. Yeah. You just play from behind the whole game, and then you just lose because they just overswarm you.
And a lot, like most Druid players cut the Zombie Chow, so you'd have like nothing small to play.
Yeah.
Most Druid decks started with the Shredder.
Yeah, and I feel like a lot of Druids also cut Kazan Mystic lately. Which makes this matchup even worse.
Mech Mages seem to be for the last few weeks like the kind of the deck to beat in
deck to
almost
beat.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
I actually thought coming in that we'd see more Freeze Mages, but it seems like the Mech Mages are just carving through all these Druids so hard.
It's a smart thing to do, right? Because Druid kind of got buffed up with the Emperor. So you at least got some stuff to beat the Druid with.
Hmm.
So the Dr. Boom coming up on the board, and I don't...
And a Fireball in hand.
Yeah, exactly.
Two Boombots. So the Boombots do 8, and the Fireball does 6, and that is, that's 14.
Are you counting already with 8? You're counting already with 8?
Yeah.
Okay, 8
so
phase.
Those are Boombots.
Those are Boombots, okay, sure.
Amaz knows, he's counting 8 right now.
Do you know that we call, like, I don't know if you catch it, we call it Dr. GG, because when you play this card on curve, you win the game.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I've totally noticed this. I didn't hear about Dr. GG, but, like, he comes out on 7 mana so often, I don't even understand how that happens that often.
And, like, it's pretty funny, because, like, people just draw it on turn 7.
Things like, yeah, no, Dr. Boom, turn 7, you know, Muster on turn 3. These are the types of plays that win the tournaments.
Divins, yep, totally.
True. Like, Muster into Coin Quartermaster, just have fun, man. So this is going to be Riddleclaw in charge. I really like this, because he knows the entities there, so you might as well just get rid of that. He, I think...
Savage Roar, right?
Savage Roar.
That is
No, he can't. I mean, I don't think.
What does Savage Roar do?
Yeah, like if you play Savage Roar, you have to tank the Dr. Boom with Phase, which doesn't help you. So I don't think. Because
he lost.
Like he pretty much lost here.
He just.
I mean, he tries to kill that. I would probably maybe try to hit the bomb, just for a chance that you know, it might hit the droid of the claw, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah. It's like.
Well.
It was kind of to be expected.
Yeah. That's a good matchup.
So the mage is gone.
Yep, and that means that Druid and Warrior left for Amaz here, and Warlock and Druid left for Tice.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, the Warrior, I feel like now it's completely useless for Amaz, right? Like, you have Warrior versus Warlock, which is not a great matchup because the Handlock, I feel like Handlock is 60% favorite, I would say, and Druid is the same thing, maybe even more. So... Amaz is going to have a really hard time winning this whole match. Like, he will have to win one really hard matchup. And then the Druid. Druid is really favorite against Warlock. Not really, but it's favorite against Warlock usually, if it's not a zoo. And then you have 50-50.
So we're going with Tice here.
Yeah, I would say it's Tice. All
right. Let's see what they end up picking out here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, either one of these guys definitely one that could win the tournament.
Definitely.
Now that Gaara has been taken care of.
I think that Warrior can still beat those two decks.
Oh, like, yeah, he can beat those decks, like, definitely. But, like, it's hard. It's hard to beat those decks. That's what I mean.
I mean, it would be worse if the Druid would be left for Tice against his Warrior.
Mm-hmm.
It was, like, the worst deck.
Yeah. So now we see the matchup of Druid versus Warlock, which Amaz is probably happy about this. Because now this means that this is favorite matchup for Amaz. So if he wins this, he'll have two chances with his Warrior to beat those like matchups. Which gives your odds like quite higher straight from the point.
Oh, certainly.
So, Innervate already in Amaz's hand.
Wait, Tice doesn't have a mage left?
No, Druid.
Yeah, no, the mage was banned. He has Druid.
Druid.
And the mage already won there, so Druid's left.
So that's actually bad for Amaz.
Yeah.
Like, really bad.
Yeah. That's what I meant, yeah. That's what I meant.
These guys really take their time on mulligans.
All right.
Ooh, he's so good. Wild Growth and Innervate.
Wow, yeah.
He's so good. Damn.
That's exactly what you want to, like...
I mean, here, now he can even, like, Innervate Shade into Wild Growth into Shredder, which makes your Shade gives him one more stat. Usually, you pretty much, like, waste Innervate, but you still have a coin, so you just waste one mana, which is not big of a deal, but he decided to just go to a coin, just keeps the Innervate.
I like it. It's a nice little curve we see here.
I mean, it's also like in some matchups, it's better against, like, for example, against Hunter. I would rather go Innervate Shade. But against Handlock, it doesn't really matter because if you Innervate Shade, you still die to Hellfire turn 4. But
you don't.
You do.
They have coin, right?
You do. Because he's going to have 3 mana, then you get... he has a coin. No.
No. If you Innervate Shade, it doesn't die to Hellfire. If you don't Innervate it out, it dies to Hellfire.
And then I would still... I would then Innervate Shade, I think, then.
Yeah. It's very good against Sandlock.
Mm-hmm.
Because so you don't die to Alpha.
Well, he has Shadow.
That's pretty good.
Shadow Flame, so...
That's actually really good.
Yeah, I mean, I would just Shadow Flame.
I would just
Shadow Flame,
too. Like, I'm just, like, thinking about it, if it's...
You're gonna mess around
anything
with
else. Like... You can Owl your Watcher or something like that, but I don't really see the
if
point.
If he plays Voidcaller, he doesn't have, like, a demon yet, so it's, like...
Risking him to actually kill that, and then if he kills it, you're kind of sad.
And if he kills the Watcher next turn, he can't kill the Shade anymore.
Oh, wow. I guess he is going to Owl.
He's going to Owl then, I guess.
Maybe he's Owling the Shredder.
Might be.
Be greedy with the Shadow Flame.
He's gonna turn that thing into a Kazan Mystic.
Kazan Mystic for 4 mana.
Yeah.
Classic.
So if he plays Lotepir, The shade is safe.
Oh yeah, the Lotep seems really, really strong here.
And then he would get punished by the greedy play.
You can just also kill Diao just with the Shredder. There's no really point of just doing the 4 damage, right?
Yeah,
now.
And he can't Mortal Coil as well.
Exactly,
so,
he can't.
So you're playing around Shadow Flame and you're playing around Mortal Coil.
Oh wow!
Yeah. So Lotep is the
play. Really, really strong.
Maybe you can also like Hero Power. Like innovate Hero Power, mm-hmm. You can push for 4 damage, and you don't die to Mortal Coil next turn.
But then the thing is, if you're a good druid, you will just next turn you will just draw Force of Nature, and turn 7 you will draw Savage Roar. Right. So you keep that innovate for that combo turn 7. You know?
Okay, I see. he just decided to push, so he will just draw Savage Roar next turn.
That makes sense to you.
If they innovate smile. He got me. Now he's like, why didn't I Shadow Flame last turn?
Yeah, he feels sad about it right now. Then he just, I guess, are you forced to maybe Antique Healbot?
Yes.
Just get your health up?
Yes, you certainly are.
Totally are.
Yeah.
And that's not what you want to do.
And then you still leave 14 damage on board. If there's Savage Roar, even if you heal, you survive.
26.
Yeah, you survive, right?
Would you consider running the owl into something just to make sure it doesn't die off so that your Shadow Flame is a bit better?
Into the lower tap, probably.
Yeah.
So you can still Shadow Flame.
Yeah.
And Mortal Coil the 5/5 shade.
Yeah. Because otherwise, if you Hero Powers, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
No clear.
And he doesn't have Molten Giants or anything.
Oh, wow.
Well, I guess.
Low tap is decent too, because then he cannot Savage Roar. So you're kind of being protected from Savage Roar as well.
And you have a stronger board, but never mind. He
decides to owl.
I didn't expect it like that.
Not do anything else. He can life tap and drop layer. No.
So we see swipes in Amaz's hand, but.
But you can't do it.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you're afraid of Molten Giants. I mean, you can just hope he doesn't have it, or he just has one, because you have already one BGH.
I wouldn't put him on 2 Molten Giants here. I think you're actually going for face here.
I think so, too. Like, if you want to just win this game, maybe just going face is correct here.
Yeah.
Because, what else you do, right?
Like, alright. He has one BGH, you know? If he has one
Molten Giant, he can just clear it. Seems reasonable.
Well, that's 4 life.
That's not too good for Tice. And Hellfire is not gonna cut it. I mean, you have to coil and then probably Antique Healbot, unless you get something crazy. Ooh, that's a good drop.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, giving the options.
Sure.
So, Amaz doesn't have a lethal, right? No.
But he has.
No, he just has 7.
Beautiful BGH in his hand.
How pretty is the BGH?
Very, very pretty.
Well, I mean, I think you got to look at him for what he does rather than his appearance, because
I guess you BGH innovates Belcher and go face. What can he do? You just play the Molten Giant. He obviously doesn't have a second one.
Yeah.
Because he would have played it.
Just play the Belcher as well. Sounds good.
And then he can use also Silence for pushing through damage.
Mm.
For me, it's always that interesting to see what can possibly, like, what can the Volok draw to actually win the game?
Yeah.
Like, is there anything?
I mean, Power Homing would be pretty sick here. Power Homing, Shadow Flame.
Hellfire Dark Bomb.
Yeah, Hellfire Dark Bomb still works. You're not dead, at least, just from the appearance. He will be dead because of Keeper.
Well, that's only 3 damage, right?
But then the small slime.
Oh, yeah, the little slime.
Small slime is going to do it. Yeah, so he decides to go for Hellfire. Makes sense. I guess this is his best shot to win this game. Like, but we see that there's a lethal in Amaz's hand, and that means that Amaz is gonna have 2 chances to win those bad matchups, which gives him quite better odds, like straight up.
Yeah, I mean, a couple tries with Warrior, it's definitely doable.
Yeah,
you know, you have your BGH at the right time, and they don't draw. You know,
multiple tries was not enough for me.
The PJ salt.
What do you guys think for Tice, though? Does he bring out the Warlock, or does he bring out the Druid to go against Warrior first?
I feel like I would bring out Druid just to get, like, I feel like Druid is a little bit easier matchup than Warlock.
Mm-hmm.
So I just like to get my easy matchup out, get to know the deck a little bit better.
Yeah, I like that idea. Mm-hmm. I like, you know, get as much intel as you can for the hard matchup.
Yeah, right. I like it. Mm.
And also probably like the focus. Like you then, if you're like, if this score is 2-2 mm-hmm. and you have to win one more time, you like maximum focus on the last game.
Yeah. And also you kind of make it maybe shaken off the opponent, right?
Yeah.
Like you just like...
It's like, oh crap, I was
okay.
up and now I'm
exactly.
tied. Like.
Like I was up 2-1, now it's 2-2. Like just one game to lose. Mm. And maybe you maybe force your opponent to do some mistake or whatever.
Oh, I think we got a little bug here.
Yeah.
Some moment, guys, but it looks like
Amazazan
Druid against Warrior.
Pretty decent. Amazazan is pretty decent. Armorsmith, Acolyte, Fiery War Axe. He has some removals for those shredders early on.
That's actually almost perfect hand against Druid.
Maybe Dead's Bite. One more Dead's Bite.
Yeah.
And then you're good to go.
Just draw that next. Mm-hmm. It's no problem.
So we're still waiting for Tice's hand. We'll just saw it just in a second. Yep. And let's see. Yeah, I like Tice going with a Druid. As we said, you just get more info for the harder matchup.
Mm-hmm. All right, we'll see how he mulligans that. Shredder, Lotheb, 2 Ancient of Lore.
So for example, if I play Druid here, I would just straight up go for Innovate Wild Growth. Yeah.
Just throw the whole thing.
Mm. I like this. Oh, the Harrison is going to be big.
Yeah.
Oh, you got an Innervate.
Innervate, Harrison.
And the opponent has 2 weapons.
Savage Art is not going to be helpful right now, but in the future, why not? Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh.
Does he want to go for Azadrake? Seems that way, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He has the board.
He's definitely not putting out Harrison Jones right now.
Okay, so Azadrake, he's going to draw it. I like this because you establish the board early on. You might get to draw another Innovate or something like that.
Wild Growth, yeah.
Yeah, Wild Growth. Hmm. Wild Growth would be sick.
2 draws to get Wild Growth.
Do you just red this, I guess, then? Just red the Acolyte, clear the board. Hmm.
Yeah, and then that Fire War Axe can just fly down to kill your Drake.
Yeah, I don't think there's a better play here.
No, seems right.
Kill the Armorsmith first, just to lesser the amount of armor he gets. So the Brad comes down here, and this is probably just going to be the Fire War Axe armor up. No stress for Amaz.
Hmm.
Ooh, this is interesting. Would you go Death Spite over this?
I don't think you Death Spite there.
Hmm. Probably not. Yeah, because next turn is probably just going to be Shredder.
Yeah.
Right? You expect Shredder. But if this was a turn, like if Tice would have a Wild Growth, it would be coming to turn 5.
Yeah.
I would like Death Spite better than the Fiery War Axe.
Yeah, just in case of a Belcher or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But actually, Tice, I believe, is not playing Belchers in this build, right?
I haven't seen one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he cut those because he has Cenarius in here.
And he plays as a Drakes, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Tice is an aggressive Druid player, so it makes sense. He has double combo as well, so. And I think Amaz is very aware of that. Like, I think everyone's really been paying attention to what's in each other's decks.
And I feel like at this level of...
And as far as we all know, that there are no musters in Gaara's Paladin deck.
Paladin. true. And I feel like at this...
I have the deck to 28 cards right now. I don't know what the last two are, but they are not musters.
True.
I feel bad.
So Amaz's hand actually isn't that great right now. Like, you want weapons, but you don't want to have that many weapons.
He has to raffle one, just to get more stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can't even micro with, like, nothing in hand.
Yeah, that is a pretty wonky hand right now.
Yeah.
4 weapons. Oh, can you fix that, Lush? Actually, you gotta, on that computer for some reason, click every now and then.
What now?
Just give us a second. We'll see Amaz's hand in a sec.
This is my theme song right now.
Oh, that's a beautiful song.
Who wouldn't follow me to the end?
He plays on 602nd, right? Yeah.
Because All right, there we go.
He was thinking about this turn also very long.
Yeah, that's why we could have it on me the whole time. That's what the show's really about, right?
Yeah.
It's about that commentary guy just can play.
But this was... He drew like four weapons. It's not really what you want to see.
Yeah, no. Rare just like slammed a shield maiden or something.
Yeah, and watch this. He's going to play this Harrison like he's cool. You know what's going to happen? He's going to get killed by a weapon. He thinks he's a weapon killer? No.
That's like the irony.
You can't even use
Museum
the Fire
Museum is not big enough. Not that many weapons can fit in there.
No, certainly. You wouldn't even want that many. You want gore howls and stuff.
Oh, actually, today, yesterday, I mean, a number guy played a Blinktron against me. He had a gore howl from it.
Dude, I just saw Trolden's newest video. Did you see that one where Strifecrow, he played Blinktron and got gore howl, which gave him exact lethal. It was like the funniest thing I've ever seen.
I'm also in that video.
Huh?
I'm also in that video after the Strifecrow play against...
I didn't finish it. There was like a minute left.
It's funny, actually.
Okay, so Dr. Boom seems pretty strong here from Thais. There's no clear answer from Maz. He can, kill it with the weapon. But that kind of hurts.
One of the many weapons.
Yeah. I think he needs to do that, though. So it's probably what's going to happen. Probably kill the bomb first as well.
I hope it does one damage.
For face, I think.
Yeah, one damage face or one damage armor smith works.
Aww.
That's kind of unlucky, but... Do you slam Shield Maiden here? I guess so, just for the mana efficiency.
Yeah.
So there's like a 90% chance that the Boombot will clear this Shield Maiden off.
90%.
I
love it.
Okay.
Wait for it. It's gonna happen.
Oh, we see almost double combo right now. So if Thais draws into Innervate or Emperor,
He's saving the Boombot for the combo.
For the combo. Makes sense.
He doesn't want to just kill this Shield Maiden.
Yeah. He's like, I don't need to kill that this turn.
So what is the damage actually next turn if the low tap dies? I mean, if the low tap dies,
it's a Belcher, right? He's probably just going to
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got Belcher Shredder, so there's not going to be lethal there whatsoever, I guess.
Yeah, he's not going to kill the...
He's still got plenty of stuff.
But that's the thing, Amaz slowly runs out of his resources, which is not going to be good news for him in late game.
Oh, God.
And okay, this is it. This is it. I was saying it. You just wait for Emperor and then you double combo, just because that's how good you are as a druid.
Yeah.
This card is
I mean, I wouldn't even look at the board state. I wouldn't look at what's in my hand. As soon as you get that Emperor, man.
Yeah, he can play... Attack with the Boomba to kill one of those minions.
Oh, God. So far today, Amaz has drawn every turn off of Nat Pagel. Will it happen again?
Yeah.
This is too funny. I can't believe this keeps happening.
So do you, I guess you don't Savage, right? Just double combo is so strong.
Yeah.
That's what's happening, I think.
You watch. He's going to draw off this. It's going to happen. I feel it.
It's 50-50, so Amaz Mav is either he draws or either he draws, right? Or something like that.
I wonder what he will draw that will save him, though. A shield sample would be nice. Of course a shield sample.
Of course a draw.
Yeah, there's
a
shield
sample. Oh. Execute.
That's
not too bad, I guess.
But also not good enough. You have to attack, execute. That sucks.
Yeah, it does.
He's thinking about just Alexstrasza, you know?
Yeah, Alexstrasza opponent, I think that's actually
push for
damage. Yeah, I like this, maybe.
Maybe a top deck Taskmaster.
The problem with that play is that, you still can't kill him turn after.
Will
he
die, though? He has the Sludge Pilcher out. Double combo.
He has double combo, yeah. There's
but
no
he
taunt
has
there.
30 life. 28.
28, but, you keep
that's
two minions
enough,
on
right?
board.
Yeah.
It's still enough. It's still enough, I think, isn't it?
He has a Sludge Belcher. That's two
taunts. Hits the Belcher with his face, and then he hits it with one of the Treants. So then he's got, two Treants.
Yeah, that's...
And these two. And that Shade gets plus one.
So
I'm not going to do the math, but
that's
lethal.
That's 8. That's 17.
12 plus 9.
That's 20... 23, 29. It should be 29.
Yeah.
That should be 29.
That's absolutely insane.
Will he armor up?
Yeah, I think, you know, he Alex Trav's best. I like this play. Like, you just push for, like, you don't play around a double combo. Like, just not too smart to do.
He actually did, because he killed the Tarzan.
he did play. As soon as he saw the Tarzan with that many cards in hand, he's like, oh, I know what you're doing. I know what you're up to.
So is this lethal anyway?
No.
No, it's not, right? No, it's not.
He just lost 9 damage. And he has 28 life. I mean, it's not that freaking strong.
If Tarzan was out one more turn, it would have been.
Rip.
Now he's hoping, please don't have a BGH. Give me a chance.
BGH is in there, though.
2 mana BGH, not too bad.
It's just like Shredder, BGH, maybe something you draw. Yeah, second Shredder. Does it do it?
I've got the beast.
Yeah, it does it. Just 2 Shredders right now.
That's
right,
because he gets 2 draws next turn, so he can get into something nice.
2 draws. I mean, you're just counting into 100% draw from that Netpagel?
That's not that Netpagel. That is a 4 health mana tide total.
Oh, okay. Now I see the point.
That's like absolutely nothing. Like, even the
see?
Best... Oh, sweet.
True.
That is 5 draws in a row off Pagel in this tournament for Amaz. He should actually just put a Pagel into his deck.
Yeah, that's just encouraging.
Remember the fight nights?
Oh my god, it was
when
so funny.
I fought,
like 7 draws to 1 once.
Yeah, 7-1. Yeah, that was so hilarious.
That was so funny.
That was so funny.
Even if Brawl is dead, with 33 life.
I don't think this combo should exist. Like, this combo is so broken, and that's why Druid is so good in every meta.
Yeah.
Because
they're like, oh,
they don't care.
Did you not have over a huge amount of life and a taunt?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
How much do I have on my board? Like nothing? Okay, that's not a problem.
That's how I lost WCA. I was with my Paladin at 30 life and I felt safe. That was a big mistake.
I don't know why you would ever feel safe at 30 life.
Yeah. Against Druid? Never.
So how much damage is that?
This is a lot of damage.
That's,
I don't even know.
That's 22, 30, 38...
it's like 3 40, of those.
47,
20,
50, 33
plus
18
55, plus 5, 38 plus 18, 40...
355, I think.
56 damage?
56? Oh yeah, because hero power. Because 56, hero power. Yeah. He innervated as well, so 56, yeah.
Alright, 56 damage.
That's I mean, that's normal,
that's pretty
right?
Cool.
If your max health totally is 30, right?
You can kill 2 players.
I've seen warriors that have over 56 health
I've seen
before.
It too.
It has happened. It has happened.
Not against Druid, usually.
No, certainly not.
But he had enough damage to kill 2 players.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Pretty sick.
I can't wait till they make team mode in Hearthstone. We just have a bunch of druids killing each other with that.
Yeah.
All right, so that leaves us with Warlock against Warrior.
Yeah.
I mean, this matchup is a little bit easier to win than to win against Druid, but it's still pretty... Like, I think it's just like 58, 60 for Warlock. If their draws is pretty decent, you know, usually you just play around those shield slams correctly and stuff like that. Warlock should have an edge.
Yeah, I would say Warlock has an edge. That Jiraxxus card is like pretty all right, that hero power.
Yeah, it's pretty all right.
Yeah, it does okay.
The important part is that at least what Amaz has is the information that it's a handlock, right? Mm-hmm. So usually when you play against Warlock first time, you don't know. So he can keep the BGH.
Yeah.
Brawl is also really important.
And Shield Slam is a pretty good card, too.
Yeah.
So he has
but
like a lot of...
We have Twilight Drake in Tice's hand. I feel like that's like one of the key cards
Definitely.
To get early against Warrior.
You really, really want to just drop the turn 4 Twilight. You don't really want to do...
It's like, how do you do that 9 damage, and then he starts hitting your armor, and you like literally will not get a good Shield Slam off.
Exactly. And if you have like follow-up of a Belcher there, like that's even better.
No, he does have Mountain Giant, by the way.
Not bad. Yeah. So I think we'll see just like Twilight Drake into Giant. Unless he draws Belcher. I think like if he draws Belcher, he might just go into Belcher. It really depends
Belcher?
What kind of like...
Well, I mean, Twilight Drake
Armor
is going to
be the state, right?
That is actually a very weird list he plays, because he plays the Void Callers as well in their deck.
Yeah.
Usually you cut the Giants for the Void Callers.
Well, the Void Call... I mean, he has Jiraxxus and Mal'Ganis. Is that it?
I think he might not play Jiraxxus. Is it possible?
Oh, that could be it. But then What is the second card? Maybe one white color? One white color, two giants, no Jirexus.
So this is probably just going to be attack, coil into giant, I guess.
But then why would you play white color if you have one demon in your deck?
That doesn't well, maybe he plays he one probably just plays color
I think he plays Doomguard, I think.
We will see.
Yeah.
Very curious.
Yeah, a lot of times I see like really good pros playing decks, and I look at them like, how do they fit all these cards? Is this a 35 card deck? Because I can't fit all
unless
this
you're Gaara, then you play 28 cards deck because you don't play Masters in your Paladin.
Oh yeah, yeah.
White color is pretty good here, I guess.
I get you're right. It is.
I guess.
Yeah. So you have the one demon in your hand from your deck, and the one white color.
That's some good top deck.
Let's assume it's a 30 cards deck, okay?
Yeah, I think there might not be a Jirexus in here. It might be there, but we'll see.
But I mean, it's really like literally one demon only?
No, the thing is that you cut the Mountain Giants for the Void Callers, but he has both, so he's missing something.
One Void Caller, one Mountain Giant. So, just really throw you off. You have no idea what the hell you're playing.
I mean, he might just play not enough AoEs, you know? He just might play like two AoEs and like one Hellfire, one Shadow Flame. Then you cut, you get one card there, right? And you might not play enough, like, you might just play like one coil and no Dark Bombs or something like that. You know, it's. They're like. In a handlock, you
would
can build
would you play
it
only
really
two
different.
AoEs with how popular the Mage, the Mech Mage is?
I wouldn't, but it's possible.
Yeah.
Like, there's the Mul'Ganis.
Hey man, don't bust it. This is the sickest one demon, one void caller deck I've ever seen.
Yeah, I mean the shield slam is pretty good there, execute there too. So he got ways to deal with it, but he has no removal right now. So it's gonna be tough. I mean Sylvanas is kind of removal, but
hey,
there's the Dr. GG BGA
turn
salt.
Seven.
Turn seven as well.
It's a pretty good time.
He's
to
like
play him.
Deal with that now. So there's no card.
I don't even know. Yeah.
There's no card in the game that answers this.
There is Light Bomb.
Yeah, in a warrior deck.
Yeah, in a warrior deck.
Is Light Bomb an answer because you take 8 damage? So it's 1 mana, 8 damage for your opponent, basically.
She can brawl and take 8 damage.
Yeah. The thing is that. Oh, wait, so, but then you keep that. Can you keep Dr. Boom on board?
God.
Okay, God, that would be so sad.
Value.
Yeah, but I mean, like, you can play Light Bomb with, like, Clerics on board, so those might sink some damage.
This is not a good strategy. This is not good at all.
You can hit it twice with the Death Bite.
Oh, yeah, that's great. So that's 21 damage from
That's
him.
21 damage.
But then the thing goes off, and that's 8 that's more plus 2 more attack phases, so it's, like...
A lot.
I mean, it's over 30 damage
from
this card.
Yeah, so that's why we call him Dr. GG.
Yeah.
You can see this, like... It's just a 7 drop.
He's so arrogant, too. Look at him with his nose up in the air like that. God. I just hate Dr. Boom.
So he's mean, meanie.
So he will attack the Sylvanas with one Boombot and kill it? That's like the common play.
Or just do 3 damage to it. Four damage.
50%.
4 damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, he almost got it. So next try. Come on. Mm. He's thinking about Argus, maybe.
He should do it with some flair. He should actually Shadow Flame this Boombot. Attack phase, Shadow Flame.
Like, you're so far ahead, might as well do some.
Might as well.
What?
Again!
8 damage. Eight damage.
But that's what you said.
Yeah, you asked for 8 damage. You asked for 8 damage, so it did 8 damage, you know?
Wait.
So, it's 4.
I can't read it, but it Boombots say they do 4 damage when
they
die.
Yeah, they do.
On the card,
It says that, I'm pretty sure. Kipo Kappa and stuff.
Okay, he missed the Sylvanas, but he did 8 damage race with the.
It's pretty good.
It's pretty decent.
With the right. Spiderlings.
Let's do this brawl. Let's get this brawl over with.
So, does Dr. Boom survive, or how does it work there?
Wouldn't that be funny?
So, Amas has to pull out his RNGs for this turn.
Do you play the Acolyte into the brawl? Is there any?
No, you don't need it.
Yeah, I think you need it, yeah.
But this is good. Like, the watch is going down as well. Brawl is good here.
Like, I mean, if you...
You're not going to get a better brawl than this.
Yeah, you have, like, 66% chance for a good outcome. You can kill with Warrex 2 of the minions. If Watcher survives, it doesn't attack. Mm-hmm. Only if Dr. Boom survives, like Dr. GG. You lost.
Yeah.
Let's see
The 60% here is pretty good to take. And actually, yeah, it worked out for him.
That's totally reasonable. Now these
Fiery War X just to kill it. He might play Echolite.
He saw the owl, right? The thing is that you would probably want to play Deathsmite next turn, so you just waste your weapon sort of, and you don't get the Deathsmite draw. Yeah.
Yeah, Echolite might be good.
By the way, three weapons in hand this game. Four last game.
Four last game. Yeah.
How many weapons does he have? Do you think he has Gore Howl? And
he plays also Master because Gara didn't play it, so he stole it from Gara. So he plays Master as well.
I heard it's really good in this deck with Deathsmite. They go together very well.
You just play you just play Master, and then you play Deathsmite, and just play another Master, and you just clear the board right somehow. Yeah.
So sick.
I didn't even know GVG is out yet. So.
Yeah, so we see the Echolite here. It makes sense.
So he has two giants. So the one giant, one more color deck.
Doomguard.
Two demons. Two demons.
Yeah, I kind of was expecting this too.
I think he has Draxxus as well. Mm. He's a priest player, which means he hates Draxxus more than any other card in the whole game.
And you can put in additional cards in your deck because there's no limit. Yeah. Ridiculous.
Yeah, man. After Gang Up was introduced, we can get a lot of cards in a deck.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Everybody getting in here, right, or something like that.
Yeah.
So do you taunt up the giant here? Probably not, right? I don't know if they're seeing the decklist. If there is a Black Knight in anybody's decklist.
Raynad played a Black Knight.
Okay.
I have not seen any other Black Knights. I think so.
I know Number Guy played because I was in his group, so I was scouting him.
Okay.
But that's why. Line, yeah.
It's like a very bad meta for Black Knight. That's why nobody's playing.
It's actually, I was talking to a bunch of the guys in the room, like Tude and Number Guy and stuff, and basically everyone that had the idea to try to heavily counter Druid decks lost right away.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird how that worked.
I mean, actually, no, it's a thing, right? Because everybody was kind of thinking about it, so nobody really... had really Druid heavy strategy, right? So maybe that's why.
Mm.
Oh, this is pretty sad.
Yeah, his hand sucks.
Mm-hmm. He he needed some execute just for him to draw, right, or something like that.
Yeah,
something like that came. So
that is a lot of damage.
How much damage is this? This is 10, 12, 17. It's not quite enough.
You can play Lotep.
Yeah, slow tap. Yeah, why not?
Lotep.
I think you can actually.
You saw the brawl. Of course, you play the Sludge Welsh as well. And
I think you can just even smash. Just ignore the Emperor because turn after you just go for lethal.
Yeah,
so it's just
course.
Like that he's gonna make his cards cheaper turn after that. Like you
of
don't
course.
Care about that.
Whoa!
What? I'm not really sure.
Why
about
would
this
you play
player.
That?
I'm not
because
sure
you have
this.
To lot about. So
what?
You have to lot about. Like it's not like he can kill it. He saw the brawl. It's like guaranteed lethal next turn. What can he do? What can a warrior possibly do? You have no. Spells available. You can
if he happened to have a Sink of Brawl
for 10 mana,
that would be insane. I mean, he watched the games.
A bunch of people were playing two brawls like
a week and a half ago. He watched the games between me and Amaz, and it's fatigue.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah,
okay.
Of course, he watched the games. He knows the exact.
You're right. List. You're right. That would have been better.
But he changed his mind. He's like, all right.
How about Armorsmith, Whirlwind?
With Lord about.
Oh yeah. Never mind.
We still have the 6 mana.
So no. So the play here is you tag the Belcher, you Deathsbite, hit the giant, Deathsbite, Fire War X, concede. Right? Something like that?
I think the straight concede is fine.
you can add the equip of War X as well in between that.
Okay.
Deathsbite into War X into...
You definitely should show off how many Deathsbites you have here.
You can double wheel one with the Deathsbite.
Yeah, that's
cool.
That's what I like about it, right?
It's kind of cool.
And this is the last turn of Amaz's tournament, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, we kind of said it before, right? So, because as we came into this match, we just saw that Warrior is going to do absolutely nothing for Amaz, right?
Yeah.
That class was actually working against him. So we kind of expected him that if he's going to lose this match, it's going to be because of the Warrior, because Warrior had so many bad... Like, he pretty much just needed Warrior to queue into Mage, right? But Mage was banned, so I don't know.
And there you see also the complexity of the Congress format, because how it started, Amaz played the zoo and he absolutely crushed the first game.
Yeah.
But it didn't matter because the zoo was out afterwards.
Yeah.
And then he had to win with his warrior and it was impossible.
So Amaz ends this tournament.
That's right.
Here.
Tyson's on. That was a good series, though.
I think they played both well.
Yeah,
just
definitely.
Amaz had just unfortunate matchups. Like, what can you do?
Yeah, sometimes
he threw all weapons as well.
Yeah, for example, when I was playing 6-0, he just trioed me because his lineup is so strong against mine.
Yeah,
and that just happens. But then against other matchup, against other lineups, you might be strong. So for example, just right now, Amaz's lineup was just weak against Isis, and that's sometimes what gets you killed.
Yeah. Well. Okay, let's go ahead and bring Tice over as soon as he gets a microphone there. We'll give him a little talking to. And then we're going to get into the second half of today. Tice, congratulations, man. After dropping down to that loser bracket, you must feel pretty good to finish this off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it feels really good now. Mm-hmm. Really good.
Yeah, I was just talking to Tice when our first match was both 0-3, right? And then I was like, man, you can do it. I did it. You can do it as well. So I think pretty good performance overall. Obviously, in the matches was pretty good. Everything.
What did you think when you played 2 Flame Imps?
I expected from Amaz at least an aggressive demon lock and maybe a zoo, but I expected more an aggressive demon lock. But I still think Mage was the right band for me because my lineup is just weaker against Mage. And he had just had a really good start. I had a feeling at turn 4 it was, yeah.
Sometimes you. It was over.
It was, double Flame Imp. It was too fast, but I didn't regret the ban.
Yeah, okay. Makes cool. Sense. You guys have any questions for Tice on this series?
I mean, we've seen already some groups before. Do you have somebody to be in group in your top 16 groups, maybe? Or somebody you want to dodge, hopefully?
I want to dodge my teammates.
Okay.
Lothar is already in the top 16, and Radu and Life Coach are playing later today. It's just because we practiced a lot together, so it's just not fun if you know both of the decks really good, and I just hope to dodge my my own teammates.
Makes sense.
Cool. Congratulations, Tice. Let's go ahead and take a look at my screen real quick. We'll just go over who made it in the two groups, because some people might just be watching one stream. Of course, we had Ignite in first place, then Tice did end up beating Amaz. This isn't quite updated yet. And then in the other group that was on stream B, we had Sho and Firebat both make it through. Faramir and Kungan falling. Tice, what do you think about those results from Group F?
I was more focused on my own group, so I didn't see much of the match. I know the first match from Sho against Kungan was really close. And I think, Faramir won first against Firebat, so he lost the second time against Firebat. That's a bit it's a bit sad maybe, but it was a really strong group. And Sho and Firebat, they are both really good players, so...
Yeah, no doubt. Mm-hmm. What do you guys think about this group? Did you guys get to watch any of these games?
Or? I actually casted the Firebat versus Faramir, the final match. Firebat's lineup was actually pretty, pretty strong against Faramir. So I was quite surprised that Faramir beat him first time around. Mm. But then just Firebat straight up got his good matchups in the queue. And he just won from that. It was quite easy. Okay. Mech Mage, Mech Warper, swarmed the board and stuff.
All right. Yeah.
I think also that Sho is really performing really great in the recent time.
He just won the Xfinity, right?
He won Xfinity. Yeah, he didn't win a tournament before that. Now he's he was always streaming, always high legend player, but now he's really showing that he can be one of the best tournament players as well.
Yeah, I'm not going first too surprised. In this group.
Yeah, maybe just the meta fits him a lot.
Yeah, it could be. I think also it took him a while to get used to a card game because he was a StarCraft pro before, and he was one of the very best non-Korean pros. So I'm not surprised to see him doing really well because we StarCraft guys are so smart. what do you guys think, actually, as far as the strength of this round of 16? Is there anyone that's standing out to you that you're oh, damn, this guy is really maybe favored to go all the way? I know there's two groups we haven't done yet, and you could name someone there if you like.
I think that Oskaka, everyone really respects him, and I think he is really underestimated, actually. He didn't really made it in the big tournaments yet, or it was just always really close, and he can make a surprise maybe for some people. Mm-hmm. And Sho is on a big streak, so, and... also Zavic is probably on a good streak. He won last time already, the last seed story, so
I think also Life Coach is now like rank one on Ghost Gamers, so I wouldn't be surprised if Life Coach does really well in this tournament.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, he performed really well in everything lately, so wouldn't be surprised at all.
Hmm. Two of the players that are kind of underrated are like Ignite and Oskaka, as you said. Mm-hmm. Like, they're also like on the same level as most of the pros, but they haven't won like a tournament yet, so it's a really big opportunity.
Yeah. What's the biggest surprise for you guys lost here?
Thanks.
What's a big surprise out of who's eliminated?
I think Strivepro, maybe.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
This Gara guy, I think that's like a big surprise.
Gara also, yeah.
Yeah, and that kind of Farmir as well. But I mean, Farmir makes sense because their group was so hard, right? So
yeah, that was a tough one as well. Same well, those were the three tough groups, actually. Mm-hmm. So I guess that makes sense that the players named all come out of there.
0-3-Sen, maybe.
Yeah, also, like, when you look at the players who dropped out, there are also, like, really good players. All of them could have
it's
advanced.
It's really stacked, though. Just a world tournament.
Certainly. Well, pretty awesome stuff. Thank you very much, you guys, for helping to cast that. I think we're just about ready to throw to Dennis here. Oh, wait, not quite yet. So, you know what? We'll talk a little bit longer.
Okay. He's playing Phase Priest. He's busy. Mm-hmm.
Well. So the next group, which of the groups will be on the main stage?
I actually don't know which of those two groups.
Mm-hmm. I think
group...
G is going to be main stage. That's going to be Nimsh, Tude, Redu, and...
Toide. Yeah, Toide. Everybody wrecks his name. Yeah. Poor guy.
You can pronounce the Druid player, right? He's Polish.
I'm not Polish.
The other group
I know,
by the way...
Zany Druid, man.
Zany Druid?
Yeah.
Zany
sure.
Druid.
Zany Druid.
Zany Druid?
Yeah. I pronounce everything right.
Is he going to play
right.
Druid okay. or...
Does it mean like
only
Druid?
Yeah,
does
sure.
it mean like only Druid? So he has four Druids in his lineup?
But then when you ban Druid, he loses.
smart.
The other group is, by the way, also really stacked. Like, not everyone knows a lot about Maverick, because the French, they are a bit like... nobody
inner
knows
circle.
A bit more... not much about them, mm-hmm. but he's a really good player. He also won like a really the open tournament with 500 people or something, like a month ago in French. And Masan, I hope he's not too tired because he had a really long flight.
He had 30 hours to get here. And, like, I think he just got here this morning. So I've been here for like 2 days. Mm-hmm. I'm finally feeling okay, and we come from the same city. So I'm telling you that I know he has to be very tired. Mm-hmm. So that could be tough on him, but I guess we'll see. We're going to start those groups pretty soon, but first we're going to go ahead and throw it over to Take. So take it away.
Okay, go. All right, welcome, guys. We're right in front of Take TV Studios, and we've kind of suckered you guys. We've made you guys watch a bunch of Hearthstone, get you guys online to see this this stream, but this is actually the real main event. It is going to be the fairest match you guys have seen so far. It is Reynad versus a Piñata.
That's it, and yeah.
What do you think his chances are?
Well, I mean, there's Savish and also Loda. I don't know if they are giving him a chance or not, but yeah, he's prepared. He can't see anything. I don't know. Should we guess how many hits he needs until he hits actually the piñata or not?
That's going to be such a wild one.
This is how we roll here. Very awkward.
Do you know what's inside that thing?
I've heard rumors just say there could be salt in it.
Okay.
But I don't know.
I couldn't even imagine something as good as that. So okay.
Let's
I hope you didn't spoil
so
quite.
So can we start? I don't know. Someone just say yes or what? Is there anyone? Yeah, well.
All right.
So someone needs to tell him.
Reynad.
You can start, man. In front of you.
All right. The match begins.
Yeah, give it a try.
Begins.
Yeah, almost
three,
there. Almost
two,
there.
One, go.
Go, go, go. Hit. Yeah, in front of you.
It's there.
No. A little bit on the left. A little bit on the left. Almost.
I think he needs to increase the frequency. Oh whoa!
Close, close, close.
He needs to increase the frequency of his swings, you know?
Whoa! Oh, you got a prize! It's still there.
Oh, it's way there. It's way there. You have plenty of work to do.
Are you...
he's, doing better than I thought. I think that that stick might swing this
yeah,
way.
We,
maybe
we move a little bit on the back.
Safety first, guys.
Okay, it's a little bit on the left. A little bit on the left. Whoa,
oh,
you got it. Yeah, yeah.
Both hands, both hands. You have lethal, finish it. Finish it.
You have to finish it, man. Well, Grip.
Well, that was what you saw, I guess.
Well, it's kind of good, right?
Yeah, there was nothing more, no strategy behind it.
It was just pure strength, I think. Well, yeah, man, the winner's interview.
What'd
you say?
Winner's interview. You've been waiting for this a while.
Oh. Yeah, you're right.
Any words?
You know, I won a tournament a couple months ago, Crip.
Yeah, I know. You've been doing pretty well recently.
Yeah. I don't know. It was fun. I was imagining a giant Amaz head-shaped pinata, but was it a horse?
It was a horse, yeah.
That was harder than I thought it would be. They just kind of walked me up to it, so I wasn't sure. Like.
Lord of Destruction. This is what you've accomplished.
I think you want to turn that upside down. Oh. On your first hit, this thing came out. So if you want the first prize, that's it right there.
Yeah, there's a little bit of candy in it too, besides the salt.
Nice, Spanish themed event. I don't know. I've had a lot of fun here. This is like best seat story for sure.
Thank you, man, for having you here. It was quite a lot of fun here so far. Yep. I think we keep rolling with more half zone here at the Seat Story Cup 3.
We're not too far out from the second set of brackets for the night. We're going to conclude, and at the end of the day, we should see who's moving on to tomorrow's round of 16.
That's it. I think we're going to...